Hey guys, it's Erica and welcome to another video. Today I wanted to do a foundation first impressions video, and it is on the Lorac Porefection foundation and also the Lorac Porefection mattifying face primer. Okay, this is not a new foundation, it's just new to me. I did get both of these products from Ulta, and the reason that I wanted to try these, the first place that I ever heard of them was in the magazine Harper's Bazaar. Do y'all ever get that magazine? I get it through Sephora. It is a coupon code that is available every now and then, and you get a year's subscription to a magazine of your choice. Harper's Bazaar is probably my favorite magazine, and I'll never forget reading in there one time that Cindy Crawford's favorite foundation is in fact the Lorac Porefection, okay? And I just figured, heck, I will try the primer that is made to go with it, okay? If a foundation that I'm using has a primer that is specifically made to go with that foundation, I do like to try them together, especially when it does say that it is mattifying. My favorite mattifying primer of life is the Kane & Austin Prime & Protect Mattifying Primer. It is also my SPF. It has an SPF of 50. But I'm not going to be using that today. I am going to use the Porefection one because the Porefection foundation does have an SPF of 20, okay? So to start, I did just twig my hair back, and I'm going to use, I've never used this before. It is sealed. Let me take that off. So I'm just going to use maybe a pea-sized amount. Okay, is this silicone based? Yes, dimethicone is the second ingredient in this. If you can see the consistency of this primer. Feels good. It doesn't feel mattifying. My neighbors are outside cleaning out their car. And boy, are they doing a good job. Wish they'd come over here and do mine. That primer feels lovely. It feels a lot like the Smashbox primer, the regular one, photo, what are you called? Smashbox Photo Finish. It feels a lot like that. Not mattifying at all. Let's shake this foundation up a little bit. And it does have a nice little pump on the top. And I'm just going to use one pump, okay? And we'll start with that. Okay. It does seem like one pump is more than enough. I'm just going to stipple it on to start out. Goes on very easy. Good color match. I am in the shade PR6, medium beige. Come on. Okay. Okay. This is not very matte at all. Not dewy, but not matte. More like a satin finish. Okay. And then as per usual, my favorite thing to do after I do use a brush, I just like to go in and pounce everything with a damp beauty blender. I find that the two, a brush and a beauty blender, I know, I'm over at the top. They just give a better, more natural finish when you use them together. I have a lot of dryness right now around the cracks of the sides of my nose from my differing gel. So ignore that. No foundation is probably going to look good with that, okay? But I'm going to get really close up to a mirror and look to see what I'm seeing, okay? Hopefully you can see too. Really pretty finish. I am really oily. I don't really have dry patches and things like that. So it looks really good. Again, the cracks of my nose, they're bad today, but I think any foundation is going to look bad with that. Otherwise, it's a really pretty finish. I'm really happy with it. It looks very skin-like. So yeah, if this holds up under the oil, it might end up being a really good foundation, okay? The biggest test for me is, will it hold up with my oil, okay? So I'm going to go ahead and do the rest of my makeup, and I'll be back. All right, guys, so we are back. This is the finished product in terms of my makeup today. I will go ahead and show you the things that I'm wearing on the rest of my face, because that probably makes a little bit of a difference, okay? So just in addition to the primer and the foundation, I did set my face with the Laura Mercier Translucent Setting Powder. Under my eyes, I have on just a little bit of the Maybelline Instant Age Rewind Eraser in Brightener. It's the pink one. Just a little bit, not much at all. And again, I did set everything with the Laura Mercier Powder. I have on some Marc Jacobs Bronzer in Tantric. I'm sure y'all have seen this bronzer numerous times. For blush, I'm wearing the e.l.f. Bronzed Violet. It's the Aqua Beauty Duo, and it's the shade Bronzed Violet. And for highlight, I am wearing the Wet n Wild Mega Glow Highlighting Powder in the Sweetest Bling. It's that real pretty kind of pinky tint highlight, okay? So that is everything that I do have on my face today. I'm really happy with the foundation this far, okay? It's early in the day. It's about 11 o'clock a.m., and it's looking really good. Usually, by the time I finish my whole face of makeup, I have to blot that quick, literally. And I keep a Sephora. These are the little blotting sheets from them. I love this one. Get this every time I order something from Sephora. It's got the little sticky pad, and I just keep this here at my vanity for after I apply my makeup. Today, I didn't have to do that. So here's hoping that the mattifying primer is actually working. But I am going to zoom you in. And keep in mind, I don't put any kind of filter on my videos. I don't overexpose my videos. I mean, on purpose, you know, sometimes they look a little crazy just from the photographer error, okay? But no crazy things going on here. This is my real skin, and I am, in fact, a real person with flaws. So if my camera will focus, can you focus? It appears as though you are focused. I don't know. But I don't really have acne and things like that to conceal, so that's not really something that you're going to see here. But you can see that I do have the dryness around my nose. Again, that is from my retinol, the Differin gel. And I do have a zit that is healing on top of my nose, so you do get to see that. But other than that, and hopefully I have on like a ton of highlight today. And hopefully you're able to see just how smooth that area is looking. I hope that I am in focus. Maybe I've got it too zoomed in. But it looks pretty daggone good, okay? I do have to say, I'm really happy with it. So maybe I shouldn't zoom in as much. Is that better? I don't know. I can't tell. But hopefully you're able to see just how skin-like this foundation does, in fact, look. I'm really happy. And I tend to have a lot of textural issues here. Your girl does not have Botox. Would love to have some, but I don't. And I knit my brow a lot. And I just get, like, I have big pores in between my eyes. I get very oily there. So this is a number one troublesome spot for me on my face, okay? This is a face that is free of injections of any kind, okay? So keep that in mind. But, and a face that is 38 years old. So hopefully you can see just what we're looking like at this point. I'll get you zoomed back out, that way I'm not quite so scary looking. Oh, I do have on setting spray today, honey, and I'm using the Milani Make It Last. I almost forgot that, okay? So, these are all typically just products that I would normally use with any foundation, but I will check in with you periodically throughout the day, and we'll see how this holds up. There's a chance that the car dealership is going to come and pick my vehicle up to be serviced. So, you know, if the day goes on and they end up coming and I see that I'm looking especially oily, I just don't like to look ugly, you know, in front of people. I will blot, you know, but I don't know that they will come and I don't know that I will need to, but we'll just have to see how that goes, okay? I do want to go ahead and film a couple more videos, things like that, but again, I will check in with you. We'll see how it lasts, but so far, so good. Hey guys, so I'm coming to you with my first check-in, okay? I've not done too good on the whole check-in process today. My eye's wanting to water now, and I know it's my allergy, so that's not what we're paying attention to. We're paying attention to the foundation, okay? It is about 10 after 4, so this foundation has been on for approximately 5 hours at this point. I do have a bug bite here from the weekend, but I do have the dryness that you can still see. But other than that, I feel like this is really holding up rather well. I've not blotted, nothing like that, so. But I've not really been doing much of anything. I filmed a second video, I did my favorites video, and yeah, it's basically all I've been doing. Went out and checked the mail, done a little bit of cleaning through the house, but I've really not been doing a whole lot. So far, so good. I will check in a little while. My eye's really going to start watering. I feel it. All right, guys. So doing another check-in for the foundation. It is about 8:15, and this is what we are looking like. So probably definitely a little glowy. Let's go to the bathroom. So I've not looked at it up close either. Not bad. Okay. So, I am oily, obviously, but, that is to be expected. This is my number one oily region. Okay. And it is oily. All right, here we go. So a bit of flaking of the mascara, but other than that, my mascara would stay in place, it looks pretty good. Like, it still looks really good, I think. That Cindy Crawford knows what she's talking about, I really believe. So, yeah. I actually like to take my makeup off around this time of day because I like to be ready for bed, like, early. Oh, that's fun. This has been on for 9 hours, something like that. So, I mean, it's pretty good. Do y'all want to see another check-in? I doubt it's going to look any different than this. Guys, I think I'm going to call it a night. This is basically what it looks like after 9 hours. Really, really happy. This set the bar so high for other foundations that I'm going to be trying. I do have the little Hourglass Vanish foundation stick that I do want to do. I'll probably go ahead and do that video tomorrow because my hair is clean. That matters when you film, right? So I just washed it today. So I'll probably go ahead and do the Hourglass video maybe tomorrow. But guys, thank you so much for watching. And let me know if you use this foundation, how it does for you, especially if you have a different skin type than I do, because, you know, your girl is oily. So if you have dry skin or normal skin, like, leave it down below so that people know
what you thought of it as well. But two very enthusiastic thumbs up. This really did work for me. So, guys, I will see you in my next video. Bye.